This morning, Sarah meets a former soldier from Atlanta, more comfortable in camouflage than wedding white.
My name is Michelle Barksdale. I don't like the shop. I'm a tomboy at heart, but I need a wedding dress for my wedding.
Who's with us?
The people who I brought with me are three of my friends. I brought my brother, and he's 10 and a half years older than me, but he's always been a father figure for me, and my friend Jasmine, who I've met when I was stationed out in California.
So the wedding's October 8th?
Los Cabos, Mexico.
Oh, so it's a destination.
Yes.
Very nice. Is there a look or a style we're thinking of?
I'm kind of all over the place.
Okay.
Like the big dress,
mm-hmm.
But then I'm doing a destination wedding, so I kind of liked this simpler silhouette.
I was in the military for a number of years and wore a uniform and wore combat boots and fatigues.
So we're open to suggestions. I'm gonna
take a look. But now I need to find a wedding dress.
Your fiance?
My fiance's name is Vincent White. I met him walking down the street. I was in Atlanta out with some friends. It was cold, and he saw me, and I was shivering. And he walked out of his car and offered me his blazer. And we exchanged numbers, and then less than a year later, we were engaged.
When you say you have a little bit of flexibility in the price point, what's your absolute cap? So I know not to bring anything over that.
Four, a little more than four.
Nothing plain. Where to go from here? Well, yeah, we're a little all over the place. I got two Lazars. I got a mermaid and an A-line. So we're just trying to figure out what she wants. I have a couple of different dresses for you
to beautiful.
Try.
Hello.
This is Randy. This has a beautiful bodice. The bottom's a little funky. I think it'd be great in Cabo.
But it looks like cut up paper.
Yeah, it's organza. Never say no until it's zipped and clipped. Okay.
Especially because your pictures are kind of
all over.
Bingo.
The first dress has the detail Michelle says she wants.
All right, do you want to show them the dress or do you want
to
just...
No, I don't even like it. I wouldn't show them anything that I wouldn't even think
okay,
about.
Okay, that's fine.
Buying.
We don't have to show them anything you don't like.
Dress two conjures up the wrong image.
No, I feel like a cow, like a big cow, like in cut up paper.
And dress three is also a dud.
I don't like the dress.
No. Okay.
Yeah, it doesn't make me happy at all.
Michelle's dismissing dresses with barely a look, leaving her friends wondering what's going on.
I'm thinking during those periods, what is Michelle doing? What's going on back there?
And Sarah, confused.
I don't think she knows what she's looking for. That's the problem. Don't know where. No. I just don't know where to take this.
I think, Sarah, we're going to spend most of our appointment in the room instead of on the floor.
I'm not coming out in the dresses because I think it's a waste of time.
Tell me, are you enjoying this?
No.
Why?
Because I just want to find a dress that I like and buy the dress.
Everything's just been no, 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 no.
And Michelle's not the only one who's frustrated. Her friends have yet to see a gown.
You're telling me that she couldn't find something that she liked to come out here in?
Give her some exact guidelines and let her go with it.
So should we go back there?
The guideline is she has people out here waiting to see her in a dress.
Sarah takes a deep breath and presents dress number four.
And I'm gonna guess that that's a no.
Dress shopping is difficult. This bottom looks like old.
This is not her comfort zone.
Yeah, this ain't her domain.
It's really hard for her to make the decision. I could do it, because I like to shop.
If I was an elementary school teacher, and like, everybody, kids, cut out flowers.
Okay, so no. Going. There's a lot of dresses that Michelle just isn't really wanting to show her, you know, her friends and her family the dresses. You know, there's just a lot of notes.
I won't even smile walking in the aisle in this dress.
No.
I really think she doesn't have a clear idea of, you know, what your wedding dress is supposed to be.
Will this dress be lucky seven?
I like this one some.
Okay.
Some.
An hour and a half into the appointment, Michelle finally comes out in a dress.
Okay, like, so I tried on all these random other dresses.
And how come we couldn't see those random
Because
other?
I would never wear them, and I was like, I hate this dress. I don't like them. I look like a cow wearing paper.
All of them?
All of them?
So you know what you don't want. Can we find out what you do want?
Hopefully what Michelle wants is the delicate detailing of dress eight.
What do you think? Like, I like it. There's only one part I don't like.
What's that? What?
The material. Oh, feel it. I want to feel like I'm wearing a potato sack. Oh, feel
that
it.
That does feel kind of oniony. Oniony bag-ish.
I don't think she realizes that she makes a dress. Dress doesn't make her.
After nine dresses, Michelle finally figures out she wants a combination of simplicity and sparkle. Dress 10 has both.
Out of everything,
mm-hmm.
This is on the top of the list.
Pretty darn good.
Eight and a half.
Eight and a half? Not even a... Look at how good you look. You know, Michelle's body in that panini gown just looked unbelievable. She just looked like a beautiful woman in that dress.
Love it.
And
it make it look like you got a booty.
It's gorgeous.
But does Michelle feel the same?
Did we find the dress?
No. I want to be sure. Like, I want to say, okay, I'm done. After all the dresses trying on, the final dress that I tried on was the one that I liked the most. But it still wasn't a wow, this is my dress moment. So I can always come back. Yay. Okay, so.
At least we got somewhere.
Somewhere.
Michele tried on a lot of dresses. But I think in the end, she really did kind of learn what she liked and what she didn't like.
I'm about to start crying.
Don't do that.
There are tissues right behind you.
You know, I started crying at your way.
Oh, you're really crying? Don't do that! No!
Give your brother a hug.
Aww. You know, she's not easily defeated. I think she'll find the dress eventually.
Hi, Sahar.
Hi!
I'm Diane.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. My name is Sahar. I am half Persian, half Salvadorian. Everybody come from far or?
From LA. Today I brought with me my mother, my mother-in-law, my sister, my brother, and my best friend. I do really love the Lazaro silk organza.
We came here today to look for my sister's the one wedding dress. With the ruffles on the bottom?
It's the ruffles, because the wedding is Spanish flamenco themed.
Right.
And I saw it in the magazine, and my heart stopped.
She saw this dress on the magazine, and she says, Mom, this is it.
Bada bing, bada boom. Good way to say it. I like that description. Bada bing, bada boom.
My sister is a professional belly dancer.
Ooh, well, she has mermaid body.
I know she's going to be belly dancing her little butt off, shimmying away in her wedding dress. I'm looking for a dress to show my curves.
When's the big date?
It's February 4th, 2012.
And where's it going to be?
It's going to be at Spanish Hills in Camarillo. My fiance's name is Sean. I am marrying my high school sweetheart. Our wedding will be on February 4th, 2012, which will be our 9-year anniversary. He supports me in everything I do. And that for me is important.
Is there a price point you feel comfortable?
Between $3,500 and $4,500. And I will be paying for my dress myself.
Diane's off to find the Lazaro. At $4,300, it's within the bride's budget.
The Lazaro with the ruffles.
I'm really hoping that I find the dress, and I hope the Lazaro is the one.
And of course, that dress is missing.
I would say my anxiety level is here.
Have you seen it, though?
No.
They haven't found the Lazaro yet?
I hope it works.
With no Lazaro, Diane needs to find another gown that fits Sahar's wedding theme.
This is definitely Spanish flamenco.
The closest to that dress is a Ravini, which I'm going to put on Sahar first until we do find the Lazaro. They're hunting down that dress for you.
Oh my God, is that it?
No, this isn't it.
I don't want to try on any other dresses because the Lazaro is the one.
But with the Lazaro MIA, the Ravini with a cascade of ruffles will have to do for now.
This is the closest to the other. This is Ravini.
What do you guys think about this?
It needs to be tighter on the bottom.
Like right here?
There.
Like this.
Right? Yes.
Yeah. It doesn't get that tight, though.
But well, then it's not the one.
My heart is set on the other dress.
You need to be like, look at me.
This is not the one.
Yeah.
No. They were like critiquing it more than like, oh my God.
Okay, let's go.
If I don't find the Lazaro dress, I will be really upset.
So it's back to the stock room for Diane.
We're still looking for the Lazaro?
Diane has to find this dress.
Diane finally gets her hands on the Lazaro.
I found it. It's like discovering the Holy Grail.
Oh my God, yes.
I'm so like shaking because I'm actually wearing this dress. Can I just say ruffles? Oh my God, my mom is gonna have a freaking heart attack. It's just perfect.
Sahar's clearly in love. Hopefully her family feels the same.
Oh my God.
Isn't that stunning on her? It's gorgeous.
I could shimmy in it.
Look at these moves. Look at this.
Oh my gosh. It hugs my body, it's comfortable, it has everything. It's just perfect.
We don't know that.
There's no words to describe how great it feels to see my sister in a dress that she loves.
Are you saying yes to the dress?
Yes. I got my dress. My mom was there. Yay! Yay! I'm feeling like I'm on cloud 9.